Find some friends and get ready to kick some behemoth butt on this free-to-play take on Monster Slaying. Oh, but this game is so pretty. Too pretty! All I have for this game is a laptop with Intel UHD graphics. Is there any way I can get this game working here? Welcome to the LowSpecGamer, the channel where I like to ignore minimum requirements and experiment with game graphics to make them work on low NPCs. And on this episode, I have set my sights on Dauntless, the free-to-play game currently in open beta running on Unreal Engine 4. Even after lowering all the options to the lowest, including the resolution scaler, this laptop was having a lot of trouble in places like the hub world of Ramsgate. Let's see how we can make it better. The configuration files for this game are located in your user folder, the hidden app data folder, then local, Archon, save, config, Windows client. We're mainly going to work with the scalability.ini file, where you can copy the variables that you will find in the description. If you're looking for a quick boost, you can use this section which disables dynamic shadows. This will be more noticeable in places like the first map, but it is easy to get used to and can provide a nice increase in performance. This section plays with lighting a bit more. You might notice that some of the scenes are significantly darker as a result. Still, if that is not quite enough, you can use this to reduce the draw distance of important elements in the game. Super low values like 0.1 might be too low for some, but they work perfectly for us. But if this is still not enough, let's use this, which lowers the quality of textures a lot. A lot. Oh god. Just stare into those beautiful lifeless eyes. Not to mention that while the resolution scaler on the game only drops to 50, you can open the game user settings file and use the resolution quality line to change it to any lower value if your GPU is still not quite getting the job done. With all those lovely changes implemented, the same zone as before becomes playable, which is way more than I expected. Surprisingly, of all dramatical changes we have done, stuff like textures and lighting is something that I can live with. It is the low draw distance what actually can be problematic, especially when actually out in the field hunting behemoths. Now, when things get fiery, the performance can drop over 30, but most of the time, it is surprisingly playable and manageable. During my testing, I recruited the help of some of you from the LowSpecGamer community at Discord, and the experience was interesting.
Yeah, if anyone sees the behemoth first, please give clear indications of where, because I have been tweaking with, like, I know, but I have been tweaking the draw distance, so I can't see it.
Okay.
Whoa! Okay, that's a thing. Oops. I'm gonna need some help.
That was Vincent Cable.
Okay, thank you. That was quick! Okay.
I can take my guns out, I don't know why.
You can't?
I don't know why. They won't come out. I can't attack.
I need experience.
Open beta, you're gonna love him. Oh, beautiful. Resistance decrease, revives disable. Defeat or drive off. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just as I die. This is going... Okay.
Oh, fuck.
Your last... Never mind. And that's it. Well done, everybody.
Well done.
Okay, you might not want to go to these extremes to make this game happen, but hopefully you can use some of these tricks to get started. While we are living in glorious times for budget-limited gamers, with more and more interesting free-to-play options showing up all the time, one thing that is becoming problematic is that for each new game, like Dauntless, you have to create yet another account in yet another service. Big deal, you say. I just use the same password for everything. Terrible idea. You know how accounts are hacked nowadays? Not by some genius hacker somewhere that is better than Google, but rather the data of some poorly secure, obscure website is extracted, and since people keep using the same password for everything, they use that to get into your email or your Fortnite account. If you have received an email like this, it is fair to say your email and password combination somewhere online has been compromised. The best way to keep your stuff secure is to use unique passwords. which is even harder because everything requires an account nowadays, so you might end up like me with a ton of paper backups for everything that you have ever used. Stop that, just use Dashlane. Dashlane is a software that helps you generate secure passwords and keep track of them, auto-filling websites and forms online. And the whole thing is locally encrypted with your master password, so you can stop worrying about anyone else getting access to your accounts. If you have half as many passwords for game services and things than I do, you will love the service. You can check it out at dashlane.com/slowspecgamer, which you will also find in the description. Dashlane is free to use for one device, but if you get premium, you will be able to automatically sync your passwords, logins, and other secure data between several devices. And with the code in the description, you can get 10% off the premium subscription. Thank you to them for sponsoring this video, and you for watching or supporting me on Patreon.